My friends often ask me for help with the same thing. Guess what? My earphones are not working. Can you fix it? Most of us would have at least one earphones that may have stopped working altogether or works partially when you touch the pins. Do you have such an earphone? Take them out. Let's fix them now. Your earphones may have connected with either a TRS configuration or a TRRS configuration. In TRS configuration, the second ring pin will be absent. This particular 3-pole configuration is used in non-microphone based stereo earphones. Since there are 3 poles, there can be 3 independent wires that might be present within this cable. A common ground signal, left side audio and right side audio. You can connect one signal wire to both sides of the earphone, but you will notice the reduction in the volume and you will lose the stereo functionality as well. TRRS configuration has two major types of pinouts, one defined by CTIA and the other by OMTP bodies. The difference between them is based on how the microphone pin is assigned to the poles. A lot of headphones in the market is usually based on the CTIA pinout. So if you have a earphone with a microphone in it, there will be a minimum of 4 wires and a maximum of 6 wires. The additional wires are just separate ground wires that you can tie to the single ground pin. In addition to this, you might find a plastic hair-like thread between the wires. They are just used for giving additional strength to the wire, usually a heat-resistant fiber called Kevlar. Without this, the copper wires will quickly wear out due to the mechanical stress on it. You may notice that all the wires are touching each other without any plastic covers for each of them. Guess what? All these wires are coated with an insulation material. You don't need any special tools. You can use a blade or expose few millimeters of the wires to the flames to remove the coating. Now you can solder it without any problem. There is a simple test to check whether your earphones are working correctly or not. You can use a small AA or AAA battery. I am using a coin battery to test it. Tape the wires on the battery like this. Now you can test the speakers by touching the signal and ground pins of the earphone and touch the other two signal wires. You should hear a hissing sound from the earphones. If both the earphones sound well, then the problem might be with your smartphone. If one sounds better and the other doesn't, then most likely the problem is with the earphone. There are 3 places where the problem could be. The actual earphone, the cable joints with the 3.5mm jack, or the microphone interface in case you have the microphone integrated earphones. I have an earphone. One side of it is not working. So let's check this. Let's remove the earbuds. You may need a wire stripper or a cutter to hold and open the ceiling gently. As we anticipated, one of the wires have come unplugged. This is most likely due to the mishandling during travel. We can solder this and fix the issue. Here is another earphone. I don't hear anything even when I connect the battery. Now, most probably, the fault is in this connector section or somewhere in the cable. So let's cut it open to access the solder pads. The solder joints are unplugged. Now we have to solder them. If you have an insulation tape, you can wrap it up, but it looks messy. So I'm going to use a heat shrink tube. Let's remove the coating. If you don't have a spare connector, you can solder it directly like this. Let's check if it works now. Yeah, both of them are working perfectly. Let's seal the heat shrink tube. To prevent your earphone wires and other cables like USB from wearing out, use a small spring which you usually find in the lead pins and wrap it around the end of the cable to prevent any damage to the cable in the future. You can add additional heat shrink tube to make it look clean and neat. We shall show them in flame. This is not my idea. This concept exists for several years, so I don't know who to give credits. Anyway, now it feels sturdy. Fine. Some of you may have used a smartphone mic something like this. You would have noticed that when you connect your microphone to a mobile phone, it works perfectly, but it doesn't work when you connect it to a PC. Let's explore how to fix this problem in the next video. Thanks for watching this video. See you again.